Hey guys, let's talk about steps you can take right now to improve your experience with controlling the infrared laser device in ground branch. By default, laser activation is bound to 6, which is not very efficient because it requires you to take your left index finger off of D to reach over and press. That complicates strafing and leaning during momentary activation, but more critically, it delays the act of activating and deactivating the laser itself. So when you're deciding on which key you're going to rebind it to, you're going to want to choose one that gives you immediate access. Many players prefer the rear side mouse button. I'm currently using the spacebar. You just need to figure out which button works best for you. The default hotkey for activating the IR illuminator is 8, which is further away, so it's even less accessible. So I recommend that you simply rebind it to the same key that you use to activate your aiming laser. This setup will also help make it feel more authentic, since almost all laser aiming modules in real life don't feature separate fire buttons for their pointer and their illuminator anyway. Rather, they usually emit either or both depending on the mode you set them on. We'll get back to mode selection in a minute. Previously, I rebinded the illuminator divergence adjustment from the default home and end keys to the up and down arrow keys, but after more playtesting, I've come to realize that that configuration is still extremely inefficient because I had to move either my left hand entirely off from the WASD position or my right hand entirely off the mouse. At this point though, all of the buttons that our fingers naturally rest on have already been assigned to perform more important actions. However, what we can still do to minimize wasted movement is make use of one of the modifier keys. For the time being, I'm going with using Shift in combination with scrolling the mouse wheel. So now, I can effortlessly get a close range flat function or a long range throw without even taking either of my hands off the keyboard and mouse. The issue that comes with using Shift as the modifier is that if you do it on the move, you will inadvertently perform a short combat slide. At present, this is unavoidable because the only options for modifier keys available to us in ground branch are limited to Control, Alternate and Shift due to the constraints of Unreal Engine 4. It'd be great if there were more keybind options like being able to use other keys as modifiers maybe later in the future, but for the moment, we just have to make do with Shift. In ground branch, we are only able to toggle between the visible laser mode and the infrared aiming laser mode, so admittedly it's a little too simplistic at the moment, in my opinion. To maintain at least some degree of familiarity to its real-life counterparts, we're going to reference a few selector switches and use them as our blueprint. Conventionally, the mode selector switch is a rotary dial located at the top or the back of an IR device. Off is usually positioned at 9 o'clock. Below that would be modes for the visible pointer, and anything clockwise to that is where the infrared modes would be. The different modes are typically denoted by two letters. The first letter, A, I, or D, respectively indicates whether it is aiming laser only, illuminator only, or dual. Dual meaning both the infrared aiming laser and illuminator. The second letter, H or L, indicates whether it's high power or low power. So going clockwise, we have aim high, aim low. These two are for the visible aiming laser, and then off, and then beyond this are all in the infrared spectrum only. Aim low, dual low, aim high, illuminator high, and finally, dual high. Now obviously, ground branch is not meant to be a military simulator, let alone a laser mode selector simulator, so I think the additional amount of resources needed to properly implement the different power levels might be better spent elsewhere. And it'll be a bit redundant to add the off function as a separate selectable mode. Having said that, the game could probably benefit from a little more granularity by offering a couple more options into the list, namely the illuminator only mode and the dual mode. This, it turns out, closely resembles the selector switch of the Designate IRV, PS3, and PS Classic, but that is purely coincidental. You probably use your side mouse buttons for things like leaning, voice comms, laser, or white light, but the side mouse buttons can still be used to select laser modes, again by using a modifier. In fact, we can use the same exact modifier key that we use for adjusting divergence. Unlike illuminator divergence, however, which in reality is a setting on a continuous scale for which the mouse wheel would be more appropriate, the different laser modes are distinct categories, so a more tactile change would be more preferable when switching between them. My hope is that by holding the same modifier key, we'll be able to press the front and rear side mouse buttons, just like we'd rotate the selector switch clockwise and counterclockwise to select the next and previous modes on our IR laser devices. But because currently ground branch only has two proper modes, if I need to switch between them, I'll just hold shift and press one of the side mouse buttons. Thanks for watching.